I've already encoded this thing, but that's just because like it's really hard to get back in that space there. But I think I did it. I'm just gonna go check from outside. It's not like the best looking thing from inside, but again, this window not gonna be operational anymore. I'm gonna put a bolt or a nail or something in the track to stop it from being able to be opened and slid. It's gonna be inactive and inoperable. And then we got on the bottom here. It's all covered up, so let's take a look outside. So from outside, looks good. Can't see anything. I'm not sure that's an outside thing, so that's fine. Yeah, this window is going to be inoperable as well. So this window and this window here, I'm not going to use. And then up here, I'll just go straight down the center here. You may have noticed I didn't mask anything up, and that is because I don't really care. Just because, not that I don't care, but I don't care if it goes black, because you see like there's little bits here, I'm not sure if you can see that, of paint that have come off the frame and stuff. The other thing is, this is rubber, so I'm not really fussed about that. It's all black. And everything that's here, I don't care if it's all gonna be covered. So it's not really an issue for me. So all I need to do now is, I'm gonna mask up this area here. I can see the rain falling on my window pane. Hear this voice again, don't build a better tomorrow. Oh, we wouldn't feel this way. Could erase the pain. Okay, I'm gonna move it over to the right, and I'm gonna start it on this side of this black thing. Because essentially, that's where it ends. So it would look a bit silly if it went black and then shifted over to here, and then the black started there. So basically, this tape needs to shift over and start right there anyway. So let's go and redo that. That's cool. Masking tape is shit. There's rough spots on there, and I'm gonna have to fix them up with a blade, but I'm gonna keep going. It's not too bad, but it isn't fantastic. It's not a straight edge like I would love. Thank you. having the sun against it really helps you to see where the light leaking, or the light is leaking in. I'm just trying to cover the sun. Yeah, so I'm gonna let that dry. Oh. Whew. What's going on in here? What is this? What the fuck is this? Anyway, that is probably the worst job I've done, that window. But as I said, like, the sun directly against it shows me where the light leaks are, but I can't apply any more paint because it's just clogging up. So I'm going to let it sit, and I'm going to do another coat. Just a very light coat, just to cover it up. Doesn't look great from the inside, but again, it's going to be covered. From the outside, it looks fantastic. Let's go have a look now. Shit house. You see it? Look at that. It's supposed to be a straight line. Whatever, anyway. Need to start measuring this wall out. Alright, this piece is 240. Let me walk you through what's going on here. I've placed that as a guide because I know that's a straight edge. And basically, that's the line I'm going to cut. And my saw is going to travel all the way up here to this side. So, a couple of things that could go wrong here, and I need to be careful, is that that is obviously going to drop once I cut it. So I'm going to try to find something to catch it, but I mean, yeah. The reason I'm not doing it on my table saw is because it's a massive piece and my car's in the way and I just can't be arsed moving everything. A complete disaster. My kingdom for a hammer. Never mind, you had your shot. I offered my kingdom for a hammer. No one gave it to me. My kingdom remains. So it's closer up top than it is down the bottom, but you can notice that if I take this out, if I put it back, see the, if I put this flush, then there is going to be a gap, but I'm just going to fill that gap, possibly with something. It didn't really fit better there, so it's the same. And the next one, I might cut a little bit extra. Then 240, and before I put that in though, I might use it as a guide to cut the next bit. Alright, I just used my favourite tool, the circular saw, I mean the table saw, and got a nice cut here. Now I'm just gonna cut that to 1760, which is our height, and then I'm going to make a little indent, and that should be it. That should be another piece done. Rounded edge. Perfect. I would say that's pretty perfect. And there's the other one over there. Alright, that's I've nailed them in. Nailed, screwed. And how good does it feel to kind of have an enclosed space here? You know, both sides. This whole room is, well, I got a little bit to do here. which might be covered by the fact that, well, let's see, we got one of these coming in there, right? So that plus the ply on top will definitely cover there. And then down here we got that, and we're gonna have a tiny bit of a gap, so I'm gonna have to do something. I think I have a very small piece I can use, so I'm gonna look at that. And out here is the last piece of the plywood that I have on me at the moment. That was the one I was just cutting, that was the big piece over there. That's all that's left of it after I've cut those two side bits. Oh, actually, there's still that bit there. All right, that worked out quite nicely. I always love using bits that I thought I was gonna throw out. So I just, it was a bit long to start with. I just shaved that down. Now that should give me adequate enough room, because once that's on there, you see right there, that is almost flush with that, and the wall will go on top of this, so that'll match quite nicely. So all this needs is a couple of screws and we're done. I'm even gonna get to use this piece of crap. Alright, so I fitted that one there too. This is the new piece. And I've got a piece over there, so now I'm just gonna screw them in. And that'll be that. That's covered in the corner.
You lift my heart up when the rest of me is down. You enchant me whenever you are around. If there are boundaries, I would try to knock them down. I'm latching on, babe. Now I know that you're what I found. I feel we're close, you know. And could I lock in your love? I feel we're close, you know. You got me losing every breath. What did you give me to make my heart beat out of my chest? How do you do it? You got me losing every breath. What did you give me to make my heart beat out of my chest?
Trying to get this poodle singing in his mind, but he just won't do it. What key are you in? Yeah, he just won't do it. I mean, as soon as I play a note, he starts barking. He just goes off.
Who's a good boy, though? Who's a good boy? Who's a good boy?
Is it on me? No way. I have to wait. Any more of these lengths, 1 meter. So I'm not going to do those today. Maybe I will. I don't know. But what I am going to do is those are in now. So we got three there. I'm going to make a cuts of more of those out of what I've got there. I'm just going to measure up these bits, this bit in particular. Two sheets will go there, then I'll have a little bit of gap like there. And then I'll need another sheet for here, and another sheet for there and there. So, fuck, it's expensive using the plywood, because we're talking about $61, 60 bucks a sheet. So you can imagine that, you know, I've got a few sheets there and it's adding up, 150 rivets or so. And there's probably going to be, you know, close to 500 to 1,000 rivets used by the time I'm done. This is hard work. So anyway, let's put in some walls. Gonna put that one in here, and I think then we'll call it a day. Well, I'm done for the day, and I did all of that on the 1.5 amp hour battery today, and it's still got juice in it. Just anyway, there's the wall. Looking pretty good now. One more sheet will get me 1, 2, and 3 plus the offcuts. So looking pretty good, and then I'll need another sheet for inside here. I really should have tried it out. Anyway, I was told that I could use MDF in here as long as it's sealed, but I don't know, I'm still not convinced. I might end up using it just on there, because I'm not going to use this as a load bearing wall. Anything load bearing will be on this side. That probably needs another, doesn't really, but yeah. And I still do need to consider redoing this bit, because again, we talked about it not being, but yeah, let's have a look around. So, so there. Yeah. I've cut these MDF panels at 1 meter, so they should go straight into the sides of the bathroom. I've also got three of these at 400, and they should go straight on the back wall of the bed room right there. this is 90 mil wide. As you can see, that's a 90 there. And what I'm doing is just putting that red line at 85. So I want to cut that just a 5 mil off. So if I put that there and lock it, and what I'll get is just a 5 mil off that. Right, it's hard to see there, but so I'm going to do that for this and those two, and then I'll adjust that down another 5 mil to 80. I'll cut the other side, and that'll give us our square, and then we'll cut that, or our rectangle, straight edge. We'll get rid of these sort of curved edges, and then I'll cut that directly down the middle by going to, because we'll be at 80 then, we'll move that down to 40, and that'll give us a half. So it'll give us two pieces at 40 mil. Put on 45, not 40. All right. That sucks, but this might be a good size for the wall for the yeah whatever. Well, those are right, and that's incorrect, but I might use that mistake. I think this would be, if it was 70 and I cut off, what was it? It was 80, and I cut it at 45, so this would be 25. So this might be a good piece to check to make the frame. All right, this is the thin piece, the 25 mil, probably a 20 mil would probably work out better. If I put this here, although it's kind of hard to tell with that, probably still needs, 10 mil off or something. So I'll leave that aside for now. For now, I will leave that aside, and I'm just going to fix the bottom plate there, like this one. So I'm going to cut that bit to size over there. I cut that off, and I've got these left. So technically I haven't tried this yet, but it should go in there very nice, very nice, like so. And it does. Oh wow, that's beautiful. That is beautiful. That's what that looks like, and I believe that's a 25 mil. Yeah, so 25, and that'll fit in there nicely. So all I need to do basically is to get a little kind of bracket thing here and put them together. Same over this side and up the top, and that's a frame there. Boom. Blah, blah, blah.